Bang. Today's Friday. This is not a great shopping day, really. We're going to, I'm going to showcase. I need to go there, put some stuff in the case, see if I sold anything, pay some rent, and hopefully collect some checks. After that, we're going to the one sale in Ridgefield Park that for other people would be interesting. For us,
well, it's sort of like a time capsule.
Yeah, it's 70s, right?
These people had
worked for.
No, they had a concession stand at like an amusement park.
Okay.
And see, that's the store that.
Gifts and
Homes.
Remember
that store?
Yeah.
They had all the artwork.
Yeah. Which one is the fancy one?
It's that one.
No. The LOOA is the fancy one.
LOOA. Oh, yeah. That's
that one.
Jewelry, though.
Yeah, but that one's like really fancy. That consignment had like, they had like nice fake paintings and decorative stuff like that, you know. Yeah, so anyway. Well, we're talking about like the sale. You said it was like a time capsule. Like,
yeah. Oh. They had a concession stand at an amusement park, so they have a lot of like toys and stuff from the 60s, 70s. But they had like the Barbie country camper, like mint
right.
in the box. They had a big gym camper, mint
yeah.
in the box. At least from the photos, it looked like they were.
Yeah,
boxes.
I saw like Welcome Back, Vinnie Barbarino stuff.
Yeah, and they had some Bruce Lee doll or something in the packaging. So there's a lot of older toys in packaging.
Right.
So,
but it is an estate sale, so.
It's an estate sale.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's cool because, like I said, it's
yeah,
like
definitely.
A time capsule that nobody touched all this stuff forever.
Yeah,
so.
For the right person with the right wallet, there's money
but
to be made.
The people that do this particular estate sale.
That's why I say it's an estate sale.
They
you know?
Look the, everything up.
Right.
And
which
they
is,
price everything accordingly.
Right.
You know, he's a reasonable guy, though.
No,
so
he is.
I would
They're
assume
good.
If somebody went to him with, like, a package deal or something.
Yeah, I'm sure.
That,
But, like, we're not really going for that stuff, you know. I like, that kind of stuff, I don't really prefer to sell that kind of stuff. I like stuff for flea markets more, or eBay.
Yeah.
You know? And then I like decorative, you know. So we're just mostly going to go there, see if they have any jewelry, decorative, check out what the deals are on the toys for the hell of it, and it'll just be the one sale we go to, you know.
And there wasn't anything else around.
Nah, not really.
We have to go to the showcase.
Nah.
For that much time.
No, I don't really,
Because I have
know.
To be back to work by, like, 2 weeks.
Well, I am not hurting for stuff, as you are not, too.
No, I have
You have a big pile of things to get to, and I have many big piles of many things to get to, too. Anyway, that's kind of the plan for today. Just, I don't know if that, does it look good for tomorrow or?
I didn't look that far.
Probably all over the place, you know.
Yeah.
All right, well, anyway, let's see what happens. At least I'll show the showcase. I haven't showed that in like a month. See what that's going on there. And hopefully they're not like still working on the place with scaffolds and walls and.
Well,
and
that I'm worried about
dumpsters.
Finding parking there. Because when we drove by the other day, they were working on the facade of the
place.
Yeah.
Well, I'm hoping they might be done. Anyway, I guess we're going to get some gas now.
Yeah, so. I need gas.
All right. I'm at the new and improved antique mall. Yeah, it looks nicer. Yeah. They're still working on it. I haven't been here in a month. The parking lot's still got a big dumpster in it. It's filled. Part of the exit is blocked off. So, I don't know. I'm getting out of the way of like a truck right now. That's a cab. I'm gonna get my stuff in the car, and then I'll just start putting stuff. It's crazy. It's like in the middle of a construction site. But all right, here I go. I'm gonna put some stuff in. Nah, I knew it. I didn't sell much stuff. That's what I expected. I'll just slowly kind of show what I have in each showcase. What my prices kind of are, you know, for everything. So you can see, I'm not going to take pictures or edit stuff. It just takes me too long. I have two showcases. My showcases are G6 and G7. In the beginning, I picked G6 because I like that song. I would never forget my showcase number. It was like G6, like a G6, which I thought was kind of fun. So anyway, I really only sold like in the whole month that I haven't been away, three items, but the construction that was going on pretty much murdered it here. But actually, the guy who's running the place, people have told me rumors about, like, oh, they're moving and stuff like that. Nah, they're not true. They're not. This place is here. There's a possibility that they may expand. I don't really know. But I don't know about that. Let's see. So anyway, what I did sell in the month was not a lot. I sold a couple of hats. I didn't. I'm not really getting any checks this time because that stuff wasn't processed yet. Probably because... let's see. Now I'm just showing stuff. Probably because it sold recently when the construction has slowed down. I expected to sell this for sure. This one's beautiful, but that's okay. I'm actually still going to leave it. I don't care. I'll give it some time. I don't need the stuff at the flea markets. I have a lot of stuff right now. And when the holidays comes, if this doesn't move, you know, maybe I'll grab some of the stuff and take it down to Florida and sell it there. Let's see. Did I show this? You know what? I don't even know if I did this row, so I'll just do this. I'm just jumping around. I'm not being particular about anything. I'm actually going to take a little bit of stuff out of here today. I think what I'm going to do is take out probably the precious moments. Mostly what I put in here is fragile stuff that I worry about most times. Like these, I'm taking these out. I'll just take these to the flea market. They don't matter to me here. And the prices I put on them, I thought were really low. I'm not going to stick them on eBay, I don't think. I just got too much other stuff to list. So it doesn't matter. Some of the stuff I've had here forever, but I just don't... I'm not taking it to the flea market. Maybe at some point I'll do a little eBay. Like, I probably could do those two squirrels together or something. I mean, I know I do have some dumb crap in here, but it doesn't matter. That's what showcases are for. You know, stupid crap sometimes. You know, like, I got this, like... this Occupy Japan figure, $5. That could sell. But what I did sell was I sold some Transformers. I sold a Transformer. And then I sold two hats, believe it or not. So that's good. I see this hand sign, Wallace Nutting. If that doesn't sell soon, that's perfect to put on eBay. I can get like $50. This I have left since day one. That's like the dumbest thing I have in here. Here's my Pokemon. Things I can sell those online at any time I want. I just haven't. And oh, here I put an inbox PlayStation. That's really good, you know, condition and everything. I put it for $45. Don't care. Not in a rush to take that out. I'll let it sit. Maybe I'll post something on online about it. This video is gonna be so demonetized, but I don't care. Whatever, you know. Just give it thumbs ups and likes, and you know, maybe it'll boost my other videos. There's a Trump envelope that I have nowhere to say. All right, anyway, what I'm going to do now is this is the stuff I'm going to put in, and I'm going to take a little bit out. Oh, you know what? I'll air this together because I didn't take everything out yet. All right, I might as well just go through what I am putting in the case. And if I have to take anything else out, I'll show that after this. Anyway, here's this Ellie Smith, not sure. Could be Ellie Smith or another company, which is escaping my thought pattern right now. But it's sawtooth blue pattern glass. I put it in for $20, who cares? Ollie's just coming, 20's reasonable. If it winds up at a flea market later on, whatever. I could possibly put this on eBay, but I'm not ready to put it. It's not worth that much on eBay. I could probably put it for like $40. So I'd much rather try and sell it for $30. And it's Fratelli Fanciulacci. That's it. Fanciulacci. Fratelli Fanciulacci. I worked it out. Anyway, it's kind of a mythical horse, I guess tiger, or I guess lion creature. And he's known for this. That's definitely who it is. I got these glasses, these Disney glasses. I made them $5 a piece. Who cares? I have three different ones, and then one that's the same. Probably the director one I have a pair of. No. Yes, the director one I have a pair of. Okay. These are pretty cool. I bought these a while back. I think these spell out or signify good fortune. I probably should have cleaned these a little bit better. I just noticed that now, but whatever. I forgot. But they're basically... Have you guys ever seen those weaved keychains? They're plastic weave vases. These are a thing. You don't find them much, but they are a thing. People do make them. I found another set. The set I saw didn't sell for a lot of money, but so I didn't make mine expensive. But man, imagine the work that went into this. I mean, I guess if you use third world countries to make your stuff, you can sell it cheap. But Jesus Christ, you know, how much would I charge to make this? Forget about it. You wouldn't want to pay me. Anyway, this is pretty nice. This is one of the vases that I got. Now, I could put this on eBay, but it only sells maybe $50 or so, $50, $60. And it's a really nice vase. The other two vases I bought at the same time, I put on eBay. I sold them off to auction. They're at auction now for $100 a pop. If they don't sell, and I think one of them, I think the Desimone might sell for it, but if they don't sell, I'm just going to raise the price, whatever. You know, you had your shot to get it cheap, and, you know, you didn't buy it, so now whoever does want it's going to pay up. Anyway, I put $40 on it. It's really beautiful. It's a beautiful Italian vase. I don't think it has enough age. I think that's a problem. Here's just a coat. That's what you call bentwood. It's a coat and hat rack. Pretty neat. I put $30 on it. That seems to be the going rate on those, 30 or so. Here's a really clean white Polar DS box. It's a console, and I threw in this retro Atari game. $40. I mean, come on. And it works really nice. It's real clean. The last thing I'm going to put in the showcase today are these model kits that I got. The one of them I paid $1 for. The rest I paid $7.50. So I can probably sell these here for less than $20, but I'm putting them all in $20. Supposedly there's a model kit guy. And if he comes in and makes an offer, I'll try and get like maybe $50 a pop or something. You know, I'll say, what does it add up to? And this for me was an experiment. I now know that it is not, in general, if you're buying blind at a flea market or yard sale, in general, the general rule for these is don't pay more than $5. You know, if you don't have the ability to look them up and check everyone, $5, that's it. Anyway, I'm gonna put this stuff in the case. Let's see how it works out. Okay, so I did everything. Some of it changed somewhat. Some of it did not. Oh, Marie's doing final touches.
Well, I wanna be able to read those games there.
Okay. Yeah, maybe they'll sell for Christmas. I don't know. Top shelf, I added the two Italian pottery pieces. I mostly shifted stuff around. So, but this is what I have. Try and show where you can see everything, or at least read the label. You can see what I have, and you can see my prices. I think my prices are pretty reasonable, you know? Do you think there's any reason for me to walk around, or not? You just want to get out of here.
I didn't see.
Okay. Yeah, we're on a always on a tight schedule.
I want to show you how somebody ruined some jewelry.
Oh, really? Okay. Okay. So you could, like I said, I'm just going slow so you could see what I have and my prices. Oh, Daisy's texting. All right, I'm going to finish this up in a second. And I get a notification from her because I was like busy. So, and you could just see stuff has been shifted around. Like, I added that stuff, obviously. And I added a fair amount of stuff, I think. You know, but these cases still don't really even look full. These consoles I should be selling. It's like I said, that whole thing with the work
the
they've been doing.
Been
parking's been bad, and people just don't want to walk underneath scaffolding. I mean, come on, can you blame them? Okay, that's my cases. I gotta get out of here. That's cool.
But you see these two Marcus A pins?
Yeah, I see
what
happened.
And it looks like that one back there, they ruined them. Never use...
The dip.
The dip. The chemical silver cleaner liquid that you dip.
Yeah.
Because if you do not rinse it off properly, that's what happens. You get that white residue and you can't get it off.
All right.
And also... You're really taking a chance of losing Marcusite.
That's right.
Using that chemical stuff, because that stuff is harsh.
Yeah. All right.